Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm doing Galatians 3, in which Paul stresses what are the advantages of being heir to our Father God. When you become the sons of God, you are the heir, you have the right to inherit the property. And that's where he's stressing, how do you do it? Then Galatians 3 verse 21. Tell me, ye who desire to be under the law, do ye not hear the law? They were under the law, you know, they heard the law when they were babies or when they were once born. And Christ, Paul, is telling them, do you want to go back to the same stage, become babies and school children and milk and feeding on milk scriptures, whereas the Christ Jesus is offering you meat, juicy meat, tasteful meat, gospel, you know. For it is written that Abraham had two sons. Now it's a very good example. I told you that these messianic Jews are these chosen people, they are the demonstration nation of the world. And here is a good example of the demonstration. They say, you know, for it is written that Abraham had two sons, the one by a bond maid, that means Hagar, the other by a free woman, Sarah. Free woman means that she was his wife, and they received Isaac through the bone, B-O-N-E, boon, by the grace of those saints, you know, who were well served by Abraham. So they blessed him with the son. So he was a promised son of grace. But he who was of the bond woman was born according to the flesh. But flesh means that because Sarah was old, so she offered young woman Hagar to Abraham to have a baby out of her. So that is was out of flesh, you know. But he of the free woman was by promise. Isaac, you know, when he was born, those people who was to whom Abraham served well, the saintly people, they then blessed Sarah with a son, and that was a son which is of promise by these saints. For the righteousness of our Abraham. These things are an allegory, for these are the two covenants. The one is from Mount Sinai, which engendereth bondage. This is Hagar. You know, he's giving you an allegory that when you are a small child, you are under flesh, you know, you are learning things from the schoolmaster. And you are not free man, you are bound. Same is given here, practical example of this Hagar. She was a bound woman, not a free one. For this Hagar is Mount Sinai in Arabia and answers to Jerusalem as it is now. Because Jerusalem was having the spiritual seat. So the people of flesh used to visit Jerusalem temple to have the spiritual knowledge when the rabbis, they were good. Not when the rabbis became hypocrite and corrupt, then they start fleecing them, you know, fleecing the Gentile. John, St. James the Just used to get money out of the robbers or hypocrite rabbi, and is in bondage with her children. So those children of Hagar, they are of the slave woman, so they are bounded, you know, they are not free men. But those of the Sarah, they were free. But the Jerusalem which is above is free and is the mother of us all. Now there's some corruption, you know, and you have to be careful, because mother of us all is Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God. Remember the parable of the woman carrying yeast in the jar and it keep on falling, and she did not know where it was going. So yeast is the His word, which, you know, keep on giving light to the people by grace of our Father. For it is written, rejoice, thou barren that bearest not. Break forth and cry, thou that travelest not. For the desolate hath many more children than she who hath a husband. That means the slave woman, you know, or the people who were of flesh. They were having many children, but this Sarah was not having a child. So she was having a child of promise. So she must be very, you know, upset. The other women are having children and she is having none. Now, we brethren, as Isaac was, are the children of promise. So we are of promise that our Father has adopted us by grace and by faith, as he was, Saul was of great faith in God. So it was by faith he was given the very Holy Spirit, very Spirit of God, which is the same the people received at Pentecost. Holy Spirit with capital S. But as then he that was born according to the flesh persecuted him that was born according to the Spirit, even so it is now. So the, you know, the people of the flesh, you know, they only know what to eat and what to, how to fill their stomach. So if they are hungry, they will go around like animals and then attack other countries so that they can have an easy living. Nevertheless, what says the scripture? Cast out the bond woman and her son, for the son of the bond woman shall not be here with the son of the free woman. That's very important. So that's why, you know, Sarah with the baby, Hagar with the baby, she was thrown out of the house of Abraham. She was told to leave because Sarah has got a son now. So this promised land that was given to Abraham was for this promised child, which we call chosen people. So the chosen people of Isaac, they have a special land, which is the promised land. So far they are faithful to Abraham, their secular father, then they enjoy best fruit in the world. That's why in the prodigal parable of the prodigal son, the younger one is Isaac, who became unfaithful to their father Abraham, and he was thrown out of the land of chosen people, and the land became barren, and they had to leave due to famine and go to Egypt to eat for their living. So, same as we are going to give, that disciples are slaves. They are bound people. Disciples are slaves of the rabbis, whilst the laborers are free men, the sons that inherit the royal kingdom of God. So these messianic Jews, they have made corruption in the New Testament. They put the word disciple instead of laborers. Remember in John 4, Christ Jesus begged our Father, send more laborers, for the crop is plentiful. He didn't ask for disciples. So this disciple word was introduced by the messianic Jews. So then they can, with this dog collar and with these colorful robes, as they used to have in the temple, they become priest again, because Christ Jesus made us royal priest, set us free. So they made the people, they became priest again, and they bound the people again under the term of discipleship, to discipline them. They were no more free. They could not talk. Anybody who talk anything which they did not like it, the master did not, Pope did not like it, he will burn him to death, as he burned 250 or so Cathars in 1400 AD or so, or in Oxford, they were, two of them was burnt, Cranmer and other, because they spoke which was not in agreement with the Pope. So, as mentioned in Matthew 12:43-45, that arid spirit temple priest who were made defunct, or who were sacked from the temple when it was destroyed, so they said, oh, we can't find green pasture now. So they entered into the church of God, and they took with them the Jewish leaven Torah, and they lured the people there. They established their shops there again, and again with the dog collar and other thing, they set up the business of discipleship. They made the people disciples again, which is feeding on milk again. So law is milk for the once born people. So that's how therefore the law was our schoolmaster, to bring us unto Christ, that we might be justified by faith. So law is milk, our scripture is milk for the once born people, whereas the gospel is the meat, or the meat of Jesus, our daily bread. But after faith has come, faith means God, in faith in God. You know, you don't go by the book or the laws, but by faith in God. We are no longer under a schoolmaster. Christ Jesus has brought us the faith. We are not babies fed on milk, but the very juicy meat of Jesus, which is the body of Jesus, which is the gospel. When you understand gospel, then you are eating the flesh of Jesus. And when you preach gospel, then you are drinking the blood of Christ. You cannot preach gospel unless you have Christ in your heart. And Christ sets you free. Because there is no greater than Christ. Christ is called royal priest. Christ Jesus is our anointed royal high priest, while we are just royal priest. We are not anointed. So in Jesus, we need to be a royal priest and have a company of fellowships in which we discuss things, logical reasoning. brings logos. Logos is his word. Blood of Christ is the refreshing drink that gives you strength. More you drink, more is given to you. For ye are the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. So once you become children of God, you are most high. For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. Baptism of Christ is the Eucharist, and not the baptism in water. The water baptism was meant for only Jews, because they were unfaithful to Abraham. And it was done in the name of Abraham, not in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost as they do it today, which is all corruption. Eucharist of sacrifice is the baptism of Christ Jesus that seals you to serve God only. So that service, then you don't do any secular work, you know. You do work for God only. You leave and become a preacher. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. Because in Jesus, you know, it's the soul that is concerned, not the flesh. There used to be slaves because they could not pay money, you know. So they became slave to the person. Okay, I need money, £100, and give me the £100, and you can keep me slave until I have paid your £100. So those were the slaves, you know. And then those were free men, you know, which were the one who were taking the slaves. So in this, Jesus says, in this one, Paul stresses, you know, the color of the skin or the country which you come from. Now the word Jew is here given the secular sense. Physical sense is wrong, you know, but take it, you know, that it is spiritual self. Jew is not the physical self. A Jew is never born, never die. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female, because soul has no gender, you know. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus deals with our souls and not the flesh. That has color, Jew or Gentile or country, Brazil, India, Africa, etc. So it doesn't matter, you know, in Jesus. And ye be Christ's, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. And if ye be Christ, you know, if you are Christ, you know, you are Son of God. So like he's giving you an analogy, as the seeds of Abraham, the chosen people, occupy the promised land, so are we then possessed, become the sons of God, and we also occupy the our promised royal kingdom. Royal kingdom of God, then we inherit it, where the true vine, Christ Jesus, is planted. This is a good analogy in that, as the sons of Abraham enjoyed the best fruit of the earth when they are faithful to him, so we enjoy the best fruit of our Father, you know. When we are these faithful sons of God, our Father, and we are sealed to serve our Father only. So when you are faithful to Father, then Father, the fruit he gave you is far greater than the worldly fruit. Here, Christ Paul was given an analogy that if these people who are the sons of Abraham, when they are faithful to Abraham, they get the best fruit in the world. And when we are faithful to our Father God, you can well imagine how best fruit that would be. Our Father God blesses you, and these are best given lectures from face to face. I can't justify on videos and other things. Gospel comes from your heart and not from this Bible or any book.